Hey everyone, my name is Jean Wandimi. We create videos about social media, digital marketing, branding, blogging, and all that good stuff. So I've been blogging for 4 years and I've always received questions about blogging, hence why I've been doing a lot of videos, which you can find links down below and up here. So one of the questions that many people ask me is how to start a blog, what should I know, how should I just start a blog? For me, the answer may sound crazy, and I just tell people just start. Once you start, you never, like, you just start getting stories after that and you start creating amazing content, but it has to be something that you're doing because you love it. Don't start a blog because somebody else is successful and you envy them and really you're not interested in blogging. It has to be something that you can do even for a year without being paid. And don't start with the idea of making money because you'll be so disappointed, especially in Kenya. Yes, there are many bloggers who make money, but do it because you have the love and you have the passion of blogging. So the first thing is to choose your platform. So decide whether you want a self-hosted site, whether you want a free site. When I started my blog, I started on Blogger. So my blog was thewineandfoodreview.blogspot.com. It was such a long name. And after some time, I saw that Blogger for me was so restrictive in terms of layout and themes. And then I decided to go on a WordPress site. So I migrated all my content from Blogger to WordPress. And instead of now having thewineandfoodreview.wordpress.com, I decided to just do a self-hosted, and I did a .com. So I just got someone to do the hosting for me and someone to do the whole layout for me. See, the best thing with a self-hosted site on WordPress is possibilities are endless. You have so many ways to customize your site. There are so many themes available. You can buy custom themes and your blog can look really amazing, and it can look as much as beautiful as you want it to look. So decide on that. I would just tell you, just start with what you have, with the resources you have. If you have enough resources to start with a self-hosted site, start there. If you have, if you don't have the resources, start with a free site, and which is a .com, I mean .blogspot.com or .wordpress.com. There's so many other platforms which are linked down below if you want other options other than WordPress and Blogger. The other thing is the type of content that you're going to be putting out. So decide, what type of content will I be putting? How many times will I be doing videos? For me, I really wanted content related to food, wine, and travel. I don't do a lot of food pieces, but my food pieces are mostly reviews. If you go to the food category of my blog, you'll see that the types of blog posts I do are strictly reviews. So when I started, I used to do recipes and I used to do cocktail recipes, but that got overwhelming to me because that's not the direction that I wanted to go. So I decided to do more reviews and more like travel pieces and wine pieces. Wine is a very huge niche for me, and yeah, hence why I decided on the three things. So the next thing to know is decide on what type of images you're going to be using. Are you going to be taking your own images? Are you going to be buying images online? Are you going to be getting free to use images? The best bet is to use your own images. People love authenticity. So if you go to a restaurant, take your own images, even if you take them with your phone, people will appreciate that. Even if you want to embed your Instagram on your blog, people will appreciate that. Take your own images. However, if you can't take your own images, you can check out my resource about how to find free to use images for businesses and for blogs and brands, and that was going to help you to decide what type of images you're going to use. So there are many sites, there are sites like Pexels, there's Pixabay, where you can find free to use images that you don't need to credit, and they're all under the Creative Commons license. So things like that. So ensure you know about those things and to avoid yourself from landing into legal trouble because of your blog. So decide on the type of visual content you want and start from there. The next thing to do is to decide, how am I going to promote my content? Will I open a social media page? Do I want to be the face of my blog? Do I want to show my face? Do I want to have guest posts? Decide on all that. How are you going to promote your content? Will I be on social media? Will I use Instagram primarily? This is good for especially like travel videos, fashion videos, because those are niches that, I mean, fashion content, travel content, because those are niches that are very visual, and Instagram is a very great platform for such a thing. For me, Twitter is my platform of choice. I keep saying that. Twitter is very nice for me because I can have a conversation and I don't have to separate accounts for the wine and food review and for Jean Wandimi. Everything, I have morphed it together. So decide on the type of voice you're going to be doing on social media. How do you promote yourself? Will you promote yourself with short video snippets? Will you cross promote? All those things are answers that you need to know before you start a blog. So the next question, or the next point that you need to know before you start a blog, and probably the most important that you should have asked yourself before you start, is what is your end goal? What do you want out of this blog? 10 years down the line, 5 years down the line, what do you want? Is it an outlet for your stories? For me, actually, that's how I started, and there's nothing wrong with that. Do you want to make money? Do you want it to be the source of any opportunity? What do you want from your blog? Do you want to be known as the authority in your field? So when I started my wine blog, it was just an outlet, and then my aim changed the more I went on, and I decided, you know what, I want to be an authority when it comes to wine, and I can use my blog to do that. Another thing is, what is your niche? What do you want to be known for? How do you specialize yourself, and how do you differentiate yourself? How do you want people to know you? What's your niche area? What will you be writing about? Will you be reviewing phones? Will you be doing tech articles? Really have that narrowed down, and that way you can plan your editorial calendar, and it can fall in that specific category that you want. Next question, and the last question probably, is how do you differentiate yourself? There are millions of bloggers in the world, and probably thousands in your country. How do you differentiate yourself? Especially if your niche is a niche that has so many bloggers, how do you want to be known? This is something that I had said in my Things to Know Before Blogging video, and I feel like both videos kind of relate to each other. So when you watch those and you're starting out in blogging, you really be at a better place to really know what you want. Have these things in writing and really just start. So I wish you the best in your blogging journey. If you've already started, I still wish you the best. Keep on putting out amazing content. We need more amazing content, consistent content. And yeah, at the end of the day, tell your story as you can do it. No one can be you better than you can. So thank you so much for watching. My name is Jean Wandimi. Remember to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. You can design different types of content. What are you, Peter? So there. So there are other types of create GIFs. Is it GIFs or GIFs? Graph. It's GIFs. Yeah.